Atamariye, tamariki ma. And welcome to Thursday, the 4th of March, and we're going to be doing some fun learning today. You guys have been doing an awesome job. You've been learning about insects, and look what I found. I found a whole lot of these in our toy box because I bought them for my grandsons when they were born, and they're little rocks with numbers on the back. So this ladybug bug has 10 dots on it, 5 on each side. We're going to use those in a minute to have a look at some maths. But before we get started, I first of all just want to say two things. The first one is a big thank you to you all for the fantastic work you're doing. You are doing so well. You are being so resilient, especially as yesterday it rained, didn't it? So it wasn't easy to get outside and play. So well done for all the work you're sending me. I'm loving it. I loved learning about all those insects you wrote about and drew, and all the maths you're doing. Don't forget on Friday, tomorrow, we're going to have a look and see who got the gold, the silver, and the bronze certificates in our class for doing lots of progressions on Maths Whiz. I secondly want to say a big thank you to your mummies and daddies and maybe your grandparents who are supporting you with your home learning. Thanks everybody. We are such a cool team. We are learning together and we are being resilient. And of course, in our classroom, we try to have a growth mindset. And that means we think positively and we make the best out of all situations. In our classroom, we say, I can try. We don't say, I can't. We say, I can try, I can give it a go. We say mistakes help us learn. We all make mistakes, that's okay. And do you know that every time you make a mistake, something happens in your brain that makes your brain grow a little bit cleverer. So when you make a mistake, you learn something from your mistake. We also say never give up. We try really hard to be resilient and to never give up. So if things are tough for you, if something's tricky for you, you just ask for some help and you try to never give up. And that's called a growth mindset. And I know you guys have been doing a great job of that in your homes. So let's just have a look at the joke today. Now I did have a joke written down and it went like this. What kind of animal... What is the best kind of pet to have at home? I had to think then and remember. So what is the best pet to have in your house? Any idea? Try and guess. What do you think? Call it out to me. Aha! So the best kind of cat is the best kind of pet is a cat. And I told you, didn't I? A cat, because it is perfect. See if you can purr like a cat. I'm going to have a try. Make your tongue wiggle in your mouth. So a cat is perfect. It purrs. So it's the best cat pet to have at home. Don't forget to share that with your family tonight. Okay, today is Thursday the 4th of March and we are looking at the number 4. And we know that number 4 is an even number. See if you can count the even numbers with me. Off we go. 2, 4, 6, 8. Oh, and we also forgot 0 at the beginning, so let's do it again. 0, 2, 4, 6, and 8. And today on my board, I'm going to ask you what number comes before, back, before 4. Any idea? Call it out to me. You're right. The number before 4 is 3. The number after 4 would be 5. If we were counting in tens, we would count like this. 4, 14, 24, 34. What would come next? Shout it out to me. Cool. Let's see if we can do it together. 44, 54, 64, 74, 84, 94. And I wonder who knows what we would do now. We would jump over to 104. So that's counting in tens. Oops, I've smudged that with my finger. If we were counting backwards, we would go in tens, 84, 74, 64. What do you think would come next? You're right. 54, count with me. 44, 34, 24, and 14. And what would come last would be 4. So you could practice doing some counting like that with your families at home. Okay, we're just going to play a little tens, numbers to 10 game. So hold your hands up like this and show me 10. Show me 5. How many more to make 10? And we can see in this hand, do we need to count them? No, we know that there are 5. So 5 plus 5 equals 10. Show me 9. How many more to make 10? Just 1. And we can see, oh, here it is, that 1 there. So 9 plus 1 equals 10. And we need to get really quick at knowing our numbers to 10. So I'm going to call out a number and I want you to shout back at me, how many more to make 10? If I've got 6, how many more to make 10? And you were right, it is 4, and I can see 4 on my hand. If I've got 5, how many more to make 10? Shout it out. You were right, if I've got 5, I need another 5 to make 10. And you might like to play that game with your mummies and daddies at home as well. Right, let's have a look at these rocks, and this one says 10. So this is our ladybug for 10. If I had 10 in one hand, and I had... How many's on that one? 6. If I had 10 on that hand and 6 on that hand, how many spots would I have altogether? 10 plus 6 is 16. And we're going to see a pattern here. So let's take that one away and let's say 10 plus, this time we've got 7 spots. 10 plus 7, shout it out to me, is 17. Ooh, there's a baby one here. 10 plus 1 spot is 11. So our 10 pluses are really easy because there's a pattern. Let's have a look at it. 10 plus 7 is 17. 10 plus 6 is 16. We can hear the number in the answer. Okay, if I had this ladybug, what double would I say for that ladybug? So look at one side and the other. Shout it out to me. 5 plus 5 equals 10. That's the double for that ladybug. Let's have a look at this one. What double would I use for that ladybug? Shout it out to me. You're right. 4 plus 4 equals 8. Ka pai. And we'll do one more, and it's this itsy bitsy one here. What double would I say for that ladybug? Shout it out to me. Well done. 2 plus 2 equals 4. And do you know that all of these ladybugs go in a little bag called counter bug bag? And that's something I bought on the internet a while ago. And I just love them. And my little grandsons love playing with them. They do all sorts of things with them. Okie dokie, let's have a look what we're going to have a look at next. And we were just looking a moment ago about before and after. So today I've got my big hundreds board, and let's see if we can put it on the screen. And I'm going to flip over a number, and I want you to tell me the number that would come before it. So if I put 44, what number would come before B starts with B, so it means go back. So if I go back, the number would be 44. What would be the number after 45 would be 46. Right, can you call out before? You got it? It would be 32. Can you call out after? Oops. It would be 56 after. So you could practice that at home with your parents, playing a game called before and after. Before and after numbers to 20. And then if you got it that, you could go numbers to 100. Okie dokie. Today on your task board, you are asked to write, to use your imagination in writing today, and you don't have to write very much, but we would like you to follow the instructions and write for us what you think the ladybug is doing. You are also doing, what else are you doing today? I think in maths you have some tasks about a triangle. Make a triangle with your fingers. Show me a triangle. We know it's a triangle because it has three sides. Tri means three. And that's why a tricycle, that's a kind of bike that kids ride, has three wheels. Oops, because the word tri means three. Okay, you've got lots to do today. Keep doing your maths, Wiz. Try and get lots of progressions, and I will look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Ha da da! Ka kite a popo! See you tomorrow!